Hey guys, I am Mr. Caffeine, and in this video I'm gonna show you a fast and easy way to make a trance slash techno plug sound in FL Studio. I'm gonna use one of my favorite and most underrated plugins. It's called Citrus. This is actually a very useful synth for all kinds of different sounds. When you first load it up, it has this beautiful string sound. Sounds very beautiful, but in order to make our own sounds, we actually need to reset the whole program. And to do that, we have to just load the default preset. Yeah, don't worry, I have a lot of presets. It should not look like this big of a mess on your screen. So just select the default, and it resets all parameters, and you should have a clean sine wave like this. Yeah, I know, not very exciting, but we're gonna turn this into something great. If you never used Citrus before, it's not like most other synthesizers, mostly because it has this weird matrix-like design. It can be a little bit intimidating first, but you will get the hang of it very easy, and I'm gonna show you a little bit of that in this video. The sound we're going to make has mostly two components, but I like to add a third one just to show it off to you. Just to give you a quick little tour to Citrus, we have 6 operators, which are like your voices. And we have this matrix design here. We have 3 filters, an FX channel, and a main channel. Most important for now is the operators. In these operators you can see our oscillators, and if you don't know what an oscillator is, it's literally just a very basic shape, and it like plays that shape many times in a second to create a sound wave. In this case we have a basic sine wave, and you can hear if we actually change this shape into, for example, a saw wave, it will drastically alter the structure of the entire sound. So it doesn't sound very pleasant, but... And we have the square shape. And the nice thing about Citrus is that you can literally just shape this whole thing however you want. But for now, we're actually doing something you cannot do in many synthesizers. You see here, it has a little button that says plug. And it like automatically makes a... filters this... it filters the operator in a way that you would get a plug sound. Usually you would have to do that in the filters, but in Citrus this is actually very easy. And I'd like to show a neat little trick you cannot do in many other synthesizers. We have here a noise button. You usually don't use that very often, except for some very specific cases. What the noise button does is literally take part of this structure and just blurs it out into noise. It pretty much just destroys your sound. What we want to do now is just turn that all the way up. So now you have just a complete chaos, like noise. And if we now select this plug thing, it literally takes that noise and puts it into that plug structure. And then you get something very funny. Listen to this. You get some kind of guitar-like, very metallic guitar-like sound. But now, because it literally just this noise just destroys the oscillator, you can hear that no matter what shape I use, it doesn't make a difference anymore, because the sound is literally now just created out of that noise. So that's gonna be our first component of the plug. Now for the second component, I like to make to add more tone to this, because this on its own, it's pretty generic, right? And I like to add a little bit of vibrato effect in that. For that, we're gonna use the second operator, and just to make it easy, I shut the first operator off, and this is where this matrix design comes in. You see here, this is operator 1, so if you look at the matrix, operator 1, it has only the output now on 1. So if I turn this down, it's completely silent. And if I turn this one up, it should only output whatever is on the second operator. So So yeah, you see how this matrix is starting to make sense now. Now we have that same basic sine wave again, because in operator 2 we haven't changed anything yet. What I like to do here is make a square, or maybe half square. And what I like to do here is add a little bit of vibrato. And also I want to use the plug function here. But because we now not use noise, you see that this now does make a difference. It doesn't have that metallic sound. I only wanted to do this to sort of simulate a metal string, really. We are actually trying to make some kind of artificial instrument here. So square. And now for the vibrato effects, I like to use LFO on the pitch. Pitch, I don't think I have to explain that one. That's like the how high or how low it is, or to be accurate, the frequency, the hertz. And the LFO stands for low frequency oscillator. So it oscillates, and it does that on a low frequency. Yeah, surprise, right? So if I activate that now, you can see, just to make it more obvious, I turn the plug effect off. You can see that it now will follow this line, and it constantly repeats that. Yeah. I recommend to use the tempo. That just makes sure that that everything you do here is relative to your BPM of your music. In this case, it doesn't really matter that much, but it's always good practice to use that function. Now we make some kind of a square here and put these lines all the way to the bottom. So we have the full range. And I like to increase the speed here. Yeah, that's some classic techno effect right there. You can also use this technique to make some cool upsweeps and stuff for techno and trance and hardstyle or whatever you want. I like to use this kind of structure for the vibrato effect. You don't have to do that. And yeah, of course this sounds absolutely like garbage, but this is where this comes in, the pitch envelope. This literally just increases or decreases the upper and lower limit of that pitch. You can hear if I turn it way up, then it literally just fluctuates from very high to very low. And if I do this very subtle, like 60 cents or something, now you hear that slight vibrato effect in the tone. That's why I wanted to do this. So you would of course never do this. That would be awful. But if you add this in just a little, you can create a very nice vibrato effect in your sound. And of course, enable the plug again so we get this. You see, now it actually starts to sound like something. It's still not very impressive, but we will get there. But now, to combine these two, I actually also want to send it through the filter. So to do that, you see here F1 stands for filter 1. If I put operator 1 through filter 1, I have to enable this knob. You will still hear that I hear no sound. That's because we don't have an output yet. So we have to set the output on the filter. What's cool about this is that you can actually have multiple outputs. So you can like have one sound like output like normal and then part of it to the filter. You can mix this in very interesting ways in this matrix. That's why I like this so much. You can do a lot of stuff you cannot do with other synthesizers. Or at least would be very hard to do with all the synthesizers. And now to add the second operator in there too. Just turn this knob. You see, we send now operator 1. We send that to the filter. And operator 2, we also send it to filter 1. And then we output filter 1. So now we get everything to this filter. Now if you play with that cutoff, all right. So I for this sound I just leave the cutoff completely open. That means that that the entire filter cuts off because I'm not after a filter effect here. The resonance makes it a little sharper. Be a little careful with that. But now for the most fun part, the main channel, we're gonna add some unison to it. For this, I like to add this 4. If you want very smooth sounds, you can go all the way up to 9. But be careful with your CPU, because this is pretty heavy on your computer. If you can't do it, I recommend the oversampling. It's just that I would actually match that to the render. Usually it doesn't make a big difference, but at least you hear now what it actually sounds like if you render it out to an MP3 or something. Here that we now already get a very different sound. Now we put this to 4. We went from this to this. And this is just, I'm not gonna explain this in much detail, but the unison pitch is important in this one. This one you can actually make a little bit of a lower undertone. I would not use that for transplugs, but this can be cool to do some interesting effects for bass kind of sound. Little bit of envelope, just play with these knobs and see what the effect is. Alright, that sounds about okay. Again, you can always experiment with different shapes and stuff. Just be creative, it's your project. What I like to do to add a little bit of a punch to this, like if you like slap a string, I like to add a third operator. And you hear that it now sounds a little bit different than before. That's because I changed the main. Everything you change in the main is going to affect your entire thing. So keep that in mind. Now I like to use a pitch envelope. And the envelope is literally just a basic automation. It will make sense if I turn it on. This is literally follows your line. It doesn't oscillate. That's the difference. You can use this for a lot of things. And what you want to do here is make a line that goes down very fast. This is actually how you would make a kick too, because if I turn down the pitch, you can make some very interesting techno kicks with that. But that's not what we're after now. Let me see what I can do here. Ah, maybe not square. And if you select this, you can add a little bit of randomness to this. And then we use another envelope on the volume to make this effect like very short. You see, now it's more like you kind of hit a metal string. And to add that to your sound, just a little bit. See, it doesn't add much, but it just adds that little bit of detail to make it sound a little bit more natural. You can of course experiment a little bit with this. Right. But it's still missing something, right? I mean, it sounds nice and all, but it's still, it sounds a little bland. So we like to add a little bit of effect too. So again, look at this matrix. We have the effect channel, and we also want to put this through the filter. So just turn this knob. You can also just use an effect here. You can, for example, if you only want to affect for operator one, then you just open this one and leave this one closed. I like to turn this one down now. That's the chorus. You can, of course, add a little dash of chorus, but I don't think that's necessary for this particular sound. All we want to do is now just some basic reverb. You see here a couple of different delays and the R for reverb. So if I turn it on now, you get this. But it's still a little bit much. The high damping, if I turn that way up, you get that sort of whispery kind of reverb. And if you turn it down, you get that very smooth. But for this sound, I actually kind of prefer a little bit of damping. Not too much, just a little bit. Just to make that sound a little bit more dreamy. And I like to add a little bit of delay, but just be careful for that. I like to use the ping pong effects, a little bit of stereo. And just turn that way down, just to have that be a little bit, just to have that slight touch of delay there. Because if you make very fast melodies as in trance, and you have this too much, it's just gonna be chaos. So yeah, I think that's pretty much it. If you have any questions or maybe suggestions what kind of sounds you like to learn to make, please post it in the comment section. And yeah, I hope this has been helpful for you. Of course, you can make this sound much nicer if you just spend a little bit more time in this. But I just wanted to show you the basics of how to make a sound like this. So yeah, I hope it has been helpful. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you next time, guys. Laters.